Rolls Royce Phantom. To the ghost.
The ghost.
That car, when you are in it, when it passes through arms or port walls, you won't feel it. It's one of the most expensive, one of. When you are in that car, you forget about death. Before God can hand over that car to you, God, Rolls
Royce,
Phantom,
the ghost.
When you start the ignition, a logo pops up from the nose.
Comes up.
Rolls Royce comes up like this. Before the Lord can hand it to you, you must have character. Otherwise, without character, you will continue greeting your neighbors.
Do you have any sobosha? My neighbor.
More futika puans. God builds a car. Look at the people that God is blessing genuinely. They have a certain character to sustain the season of harvest. Because the season of harvest, when it comes upon you, and you've not built character, you can leave your wife. You leave your wife and your children. Because you never built character.
Amen.
So then the Lord will make sure you live an average life the rest of your life, because you've never built character. And then you begin to blame your mother. Your mother is innocent. Or you blame your father. No, my father is not your father. Build capacity. Stamina. That will sustain a 1 million blessing when it comes to you. That is a 1 million for many of you. Are we following? They are seasons. Look at this other season. In John 5 verse 4.
You want to find this one?
John 5. Listen.
You want to find?
Are we there? Look at that. This was the pool of Bethsaida. For an angel, go to verse 3. John 5, verse 3.
You want to find verse 3?
Verse 2.
2.
Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market the pool. Now listen. When you hate scripture, when you feel bad when reading the word, you are in a backslidden state. You need to come back to the Lord. I'll
start enjoying the
scripture.
Now there is a Jerusalem by the ship market, a
pool,
which is called in the Hebrew tongue
Bethsaida, Bethsaida,
having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, of blind, what, withered. These were sick people waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and traveled the water. Did you hear that? So healing at this time was not always.
It
was in a certain season. That's why these people will gather around the pool of Bethsaida, waiting for the season to come. God's blessings sometimes are seasonal. They were waiting for an angel to stir the water. So everyone was under expectation. Expectation is what gives you God's blessing. When you are in God's presence and you are not expecting nothing, you will go home with nothing. It is those with expectation that get a blessing from
God.
When you are in church, you sit like a whole flower. No, no expectation, you go empty. These folks, impotent folks, the lame, withered, they were waiting for the season.
But now,
right season.
Amen.
Because in that season, an angel of healing stepped in the water. Stared the water. The moment the water was stirred, those that were under expectation, they went in first. It is those that are pulling from the Lord that get a blessing from the Lord. Don't be a down Christian. Don't be a lazy believer. Refuse to be lazy. They are lazy Christians who sit in church as if they've got no backbone. Don't be such a one. Refuse to be lazy. The kingdom of God suffers violence. You need to be violent. Master, I need your blessing. Jacob one time, he said, Lord, I'll get hold of you. If you don't bless me, I will not leave you. You've got to get violent for you to get a blessing. Don't be a lazy Christian. You've got to charge your spirit. Challenge your unbelief. Wrestled with an angel the whole night until you change me. I am a supplanter. I am a thief.
I am a sinner. I robbed. I'm not God. Change me. Or I will not leave you. That's what God is expecting for us. And the angel touched him. That was Jesus. Hallelujah. And Jacob became a limping priest. He began to limp. Why? When God touches you, He will live an indelible mark. Your neighbor will know. Everyone will know. This one has been touched by the Master. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When God touches you, He will leave a mark on you. Let the mark of Yeshua come upon somebody. Come upon you. Come upon your life. In the name of the Lord.
You may be seated.
And Jacob was a different person from that moment on. He was no longer afraid to go and meet Esau, because his name changed from a liar to prince with God, from a supplanter. Hallelujah. From Jacob to Israel. And he went to meet his brother Esau. He was not afraid. When you are touched by the angel, fear leaves you.
Did not touch you.
It was Saint Paul. He was touched by the pillar of fire on his road to Damascus. Fear left him. Agabus came and got the belt from Paul. Says, you are bound, you are going to Jerusalem bound. He says, I'm already bound in the spirit. He was already bound. He had no fear. When the Lord touches you, fear will leave you.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory be to God.
These people under expectation.
Yeah.
That are yearning. We want to build people that have hunger.
And
people that sit in church that they've never eaten for years. I refuse that spirit. Refuse that what you are doing. It's a demon. Did you refuse it? You can't cast it down.
There's no preacher that wants a church that's cold. Like in a refrigerator. -20 degrees.
No, brother.
Bible says they were there in the upper room.
They were young men there. Middle aged. There were old guys there. Hallelujah. The problem, you have no Holy Ghost. If you are the Holy Ghost, you stagger like men. Mary staggered. Glory be to God. They staggered at the new wine.
Listen to me. When you take wine, give a young person strong wine. They will lose their balance. You give a middle-aged, they will lose
balance.
You give an old person, it will be worse.
Amen.
Why? Because of what is contained in the wine. There is a content inside.
Amen. that stimulates your body. It will bring you alive. You find a person that's drunk. He wants to be a friend with everyone. Everyone, they come alive. The devil is a copyright. The devil looked equipped in the upper room. He saw how Christians were intoxicated by the heavenly wine that came in the form of a prophet, leaks of fire. They were baptized by the Holy Ghost and they staggered and drank men and women. Somebody said these people are drunk with, they are full of new wine. Peter said, this is joy too. Verse 28, it shall come to pass. What you do, this is Isaiah. 28, this is that which I just spoke about. It shall come to pass. Mary, the mother of Jesus,
be my wife.
Now we're not saying now you start staggering, you make it, you will start impersonating.
Yeah. This one is good.
We don't want to make things.
It is.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sometimes the Holy Ghost can make you just begin to laugh. Feeling certain peace. Sometimes it can make you cry. Sometimes it can make you scream. Not because somebody is intoxicated and is screaming. Also, start screaming. Wala na katu mine.
Iwe suna kolea na siwe. Itu mine saba.
You are impersonating.
Yeah, you go there.
Let it happen to you. Tia, teach, individual. Matimu tu. Power
at the invitation. That we have the hand of Yeshua. Tia, something will be standing.
See, somebody will do it. We are still at the pool of Bethsaida.
But still, the chapel inside,
everyone is running, passing this
place.
In the season of your blessing, let no one take your blessing. In your season, everyone planted in your life to rob you
of your God-given season. I prophesy. In the name of Jesus, let the hand of Yeshua be heavy on them. And the one orchestrating to abort your blessing, let them go down. Let them perish. In the name of the Lord Jesus. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. Anyone that has planned to push you down, in the name of Jesus Christ, mighty name of Jesus Christ, anybody that has planned, has dug a hole that you may go in, all your children, they'll go down the fire. I said, they'll go down the fire. They'll go down the fire. They'll perish. Let the hand of Yeshua be heavy on anyone that God has taken your name. He has taken your picture. The workers, we want to get it all. This advantage. I prophesy. I prophesy with my eyes open, my ears open. I prophesy. You don't know what I'm saying. I say anybody that enemy in your family, they planned it to kill your seed. Backfire! 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 Backfire!